So as our topic is 1-1, so sir, we have discussed some property and you ask about the formula that this formula NPR is applicable or not. So suppose, as I told you that if you have, suppose this is A set and this is B set, okay? Now if you have three elements in A, B and C namely, and here you have 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many elements in B? 4. How many elements in A? 3. So I told you about that. How many 1-1 function you can make from set A to set B? The formula is N of number of elements in E, B, sorry, permutation with number of elements in A. That will be equal to 4P3 right now. Answer will be 4 factorial upon 4 minus 3 factorial is equal to 4 into 3 factorial. Yeah, you can say 4 into 3 into 2, 1 upon 1 factorial. That is answer is 24. How is it possible? Suppose for A you have 4 choices. A can map 1, 2, 3, 4. It means for A you have 4 choices. ठीक है? And it is a 1-1 function. So A must be connect to any one of the number 1, 2, 3, 4. Suppose A connect to 1. Okay? After that, for B, you have choice. If A connect to 1, for B you have 3 choices. So for A you have choice 4, for B you have choice 3. You can connect B like this. So B has 3 choices. It can connect to 2, it can connect to 3, it can connect to 4. 1, if it will connect to 2, that is fixed. Now B can't connect to 3 and 4. So for C, how many choices you have?
2.
Suppose B connect to 2. Okay. Now C has how many choices? 2. So the multiplication is equal to?
4.
So that is the formula. For if you have number of elements in set B, permutation with number of elements at A, that total possible 1-1 functions you can make. Clear? Yesterday you have doubt about it, the formula that you are telling me that there will be a combination. Combination we use when we have to make select the things. Okay? When there is only permutation, we have to arrange the things, then we will use permutations, okay? So here permutation will apply, and if this set B, and for this formula that number of elements set in B must be greater than equal to number of set in A. Clear? Suppose,
लास्ट पेज नहीं आएगा
सपोज देयर इज 4 एलिमेंट इज नॉट प्रेजेंट हियर then you have this number of elements in B is 3 and number of elements in A is also 3. That means answer will be 3P3 and 3P3 is equal to 3 factorial upon 3 minus 3 factorial. That means 3 factorial upon 0 factorial.
6.
Answer is 6.
6.
Clear?
6.
Clear? Now, you can see that for A we have 3 choice, for B have we 2 choice, and for C we have only 1 choice. So, multiplication for this is 3 into 2 into 1. So, you can easily verify your answer that there are 611 functions. You can make 611 functions. Okay? This formula is clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Now, next proceed to second topic. There are some special functions that you have introduced in 11th class also. Greatest integer function, you all know. What is greatest integer function?
No, sir.
Forget about. Okay. Greatest integer function. क्यों नहीं है भाई आपका वन वन फंक्शन भी है और वन टू फंक्शन भी है वन वन फंक्शन का जो मैंने थ्योरी लिखवाया वो मैंने एमसीक्यू के साथ सारा लिखवा दिया अब हाउ टू डील विद एनसीईआरटी थोड़ा कंसेप्ट इससे बिल्डअप हो जाएगा बिकॉज हियर वी प्रूव ऑल द क्वेश्चंस सो यू विल सी व्हाट इज वन वन फंक्शन व्हाट इज द कंडीशन फॉर वन वन फंक्शन सो मेनी एग्जाम्पल वी विल डू सो फॉर एनसीईआरटी योर बेसिक विल बी क्लियर देन वी विल स्टार्ट एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चंस ओके ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर फंक्शन It is denoted by what happened? If you want to understand this function, greatest integer function. What is the meaning of greatest integer function? Suppose you have, for from example, you start, Manjit, please keep quiet. If you see square bracket, this is called a square bracket on any integer, it will read as greatest integer. If you see any integer in the square bracket. That is read it as greatest integer function. Clear? Now, if I have to find the value of greatest integer value of 3.4, what does it mean? It means that up to 3.4, what is the greatest integer?
3.
So, value of 3.4 is
3.
Clear? The definition of greatest integer function is whenever you have a number. Up to that number, what is the greatest integer you can find? Suppose you have a point 3.4. Up to 3.4, what is the greatest integer? That is 3. So, the value of greatest integer of 3.4 is 3. The value of 3.5 is?
3.
The value of 3.6 is?
3.
Clear? Now, if you have, suppose, minus 1.6. Answer is minus 2. For this, we will start with the Now, I will give you the way how you will learn this greatest integer function. In NCERT, there is a graph where he circle over here. But I used to be here because I have to find the values in that interval. Suppose. You are here, yani ki from any point 0 to 1, this whole interval, in this whole interval, the greatest integer value is 0. Here, from any point from 1 to 2, the greatest integer value is 1. So, focus on the left hand side, whereas these points will take the value of the intervals. Always left part you have to focus of the interval. Suppose you are on the point -3.6
-4.
Clear? So this will solve your problems, solve your doubt that which value you should take whenever you will dealing with greatest integer function. In NCERT there is a different graph, but because I have to find the values, what values it will take, so I change that graph and make circle on the left side. In the NCERT graph, he will circle on the right side. That means it should, he said that